Cause I'm ugly with a capital U. And I don't need a mirror to see that it's true. I'm ugly with a capital U.
Okay, a little self-esteem issue there.
Yeah, that's true. That was high school.
Okay, well, welcome to the 9th edition of Listen Up Illinois. My name is Ed Hawks, and I'm here with Elizabeth Simpson, and we're coming to you from the wonderful Urbana City Council Chambers in beautiful downtown Urbana.
Beautiful Urbana, that's what it is.
Yeah, it's a great town, and Up TV is a great thing to have in,
absolutely,
here in Urbana. So I have Elizabeth Simpson. She has a lot of musical styles that she does. I first heard her at the WRFU benefit. She did an a cappella Irish song, that ballad, that the whole room got quiet. So she has a wonderful voice, as you'll find out. And she's agreed to be my guest today, and I'm happy about that. And she has another special guest that we'll introduce later when she gets to the jazz style.
Mm-hmm.
So usually we start out, we had talked about on the phone, I asked you what your musical influences were, and you had an unusual answer. You said it was the radio, so you want to talk a little bit about that?
Sure, absolutely. You know, I always made up songs when I was little, just going around. One of my earliest memories was making up a little song about Halloween. But where music really came into my life was through the radio, and especially from fifth grade on through high school and beyond. I would listen to music in the morning. I would wake up to an alarm clock radio. I would go to school. Before school, I would meet with people. We'd goof off and play music before school, and then I'd come home after school, turn the radio back on, turn CDs back on, cassettes, and then CDs later on. And music was my solace. It was one of my best friends.
So how did you listen to different radio stations then? How did you get so many styles?
In the beginning, I did listen to 96 TIC FM, which was kind of a pop. I was into the pop music for a long time. And it wasn't until high school when I was in I grew up in Massachusetts, in the Allstate chorus, and I met somebody who played saxophone, jazz saxophone. And it was one of those things where I had a crush on the guy and the guy liked jazz. So I looked into it just for the sake of, and my affection for jazz has way outlasted my affection for that young man. But that's where I started off with the jazz. And before that, you know, I had some friends in high school who played music, and one of them, E.J. Dawson, was the guy who introduced me to Juliana Hatfield, who wrote that song I just played. And so that was a lot of my early influence, was her and the Blake Babies. This, you know, petite woman with a small voice singing about things that really mattered to her and for me were really relevant.
So it wasn't just the radio. You did have a lot
mm-hmm.
of people who were musical influences
mm-hmm.
as well. So
mm-hmm, absolutely.
Okay. Well, you want to do another song? You
sure.
have the original? Are they doing some
yeah.
originals?
Yeah, I will pull out some original. A lot of the songs that I write are, they're kind of almost, not fantasies, but exaggerated versions of my real life. So if I'm bummed out, I write a really bummed out song. If I kind of like somebody a little bit, I write the song as though they're like the best person in the world. And so I knew this person in college, and so I wrote the song towards them, although it's kind of stronger than I felt towards them. So it's called John Song, because that's the name. But I changed it because I forgot he's like 10 years past. So I call it I Want You To.
I'll sit with you to
Yes, yes.
But you mind a little bit of Joni Mitchell.
Oh, yep. Who I didn't even hear about until I was out of college, unfortunately, but have since.
Well, we were talking a little bit about how you come to write a song.
Mm-hmm.
I think you said that you sometimes you walk or ride, or so. Can you tell us a little bit about how you come up with an idea and how it develops into a song?
Sure, absolutely. I have owned a car at some point. Two points in my life, but mostly I'm biking and I'm walking everywhere and I'm always singing. So whether it is that I'll hear a little snatch of just some melodic line and I'll just keep singing it over and over again, you can do that when you're walking, you know, you just sing in time with your own feet. And oftentimes I will start off with just a melodic thing and then I'll go back and I'll look at poetry that I've got laying around, or I'll kind of keep a stash of ideas for descriptions of different things, and so I'll mix and match that. Other times I'll decide, you know, I need to write a song because I've got something in me that I need to get out in some way. And in those moments, I may, you know, write for a couple pages and then just start noodling around until I find something. And then just kind of ad lib with that writing fresh in my mind until something fits. And sometimes I'll plow through a song and write it, you know, in a couple hours or even faster. But a lot of times I let the songs lie and I'll just come back to them over time and add more things. And so there's songs that I've changed in the past couple months that I wrote, you know, 8 years ago, but now I've switched them around, or I'll cannibalize old songs to make new ones that I feel are, you know, more melodic or more interesting.
So they're always a work in progress.
Yeah, because you can do that.
Yeah,
you know, it's funny.
Yours.
Absolutely.
So you can change any time you want.
Absolutely.
Make it new, make it fresh.
And no one will know, that's the thing. Since I don't have the international fan base yet, I can change my songs and no one's going to say, you know, what happened to the old version?
Right. Well, Bob Dylan always kind of did his different ways. He never did them the same way all the
mm-hmm.
time. So.
Yep. And that brings the human element into the song, that it's not a recording. You are a human being. So those little nuances, and that's the benefit of what I consider to be real live music, where people are improvising, it matters that you're seeing them live. It's different than you'd hear on the recording.
Right, yeah. That's what's so nice about being live.
Absolutely.
Do you have another song for us?
Sure. Let's see. I will do... Well, this was a song that I basically had written down this idea, and then I built a song around the idea. And it's that, as you'll hear, that feelings of resentment that are inside a person are some of the most damaging things to that person that they can be doing. Seething is a pretty damaging thing to the person who's doing it.
Instead of
understanding. I'm impatient when it comes to these things, but I'm learning.
The personal experience.
Oh yeah.
Of course.
I think. Oh yeah.
Everybody's got that.
Oh yeah. Yeah. You get stuck on that stuff.
We were talking about what brought you to Champaign, and you're kind of a community organizer.
Mm-hmm.
Would you go so far as to say activist?
I would go beyond activist. Yeah, I'll just plow straight to that. Yeah.
So does that ever enter into your songwriting?
Absolutely. In particular, where it crosses over is the tradition of street ballads. Songs that are used to tell news or to tell stories about what's going on. Sometimes they're used to tell recent events, or at the time they were created, recent events, and sometimes they're used to just keep memories alive about historic happenings. So I definitely have picked up on the tradition of learning some of other people's street ballads, and then at times changing lyrics and things like that with traditional songs, as we'll see later on in the show as well. But I've got one of the traditions that is very strong is the Irish tradition of Irish street ballads. So that song that you mentioned from the concert is one that I'd like to share today, that comes from the history of the folks of Ireland trying to gather together to oppose the enclosure movement and at that time opposing the British Empire. It's called The Wind That Shakes the Barley.
Okay. You want to do that now?
Yeah, that'd be great. Okay. Back up a little bit because it ends up being a little more boisterous. He sat me in the barley green. I sat me with my true love. My sad heart strove the two between, the old love and the new love. The old for her, the new that makes me think on Ireland dearly. And soft the wind blow down the glade and shook the golden barley. 'Twas hard the woeful words to frame and break the ties that bound us, yet harder still to bear the shame of foreign chains around us. And so I said the mountain glen I'll meet at morning early, and I'll join the bold united men while soft wind shook the barley. 'Twas sad I brushed away her tears, my fond arm round her flinging, when a foeman's shot burst on our ears throughout the wild woods ringing. A bullet pierced my true love's side in life's young spring so early. And on my breast in blood she died, while soft wind shook the barley. But blood for blood, without remorse, I've taken at our Lord's hollow, and I've lain my true love's clay-like corpse, where I full soon must follow. Around her grave I've wandered drear, noon, night, and morning early, and sad my heart whenever I hear the wind that shakes the barley.
Well, that's a great song.
Yeah, isn't it? And what a great way, you know, imagine you just walking down the streets of downtown Urbana and Champaign, and there'd be people calling out the news in song. You know, it's a great tradition.
What, do you have any idea when that song was written?
I don't. I could find out, but I don't know.
Yeah.
Old.
It's old.
You know, a couple hundred years.
Yeah. Well, we talked on the phone before this, and we were talking about, I asked you if you took vocal lessons, mm-hmm. and you had some interesting ideas on that, so.
Sure, yeah. A lot of people who aren't doing classical singing avoid professional training for fear that they're going to end up with an opera voice, and they don't want one. And that's not the case. It doesn't have to be the case if you find the right teacher. And I've had bad experiences with teachers who really wanted me to do the classical canon only, or if I was doing a more modern song, they'd want me to do it in the, you know, can you just imagine singing any modern song in an operatic voice? It can be terrible. But luckily I found Megan Smith, who's the conductor of the Amazon Chorus in town, and she's an absolute gem. And so what she wants to do is support my singing style, whatever way I want to sing. She wants to make sure I have that support underneath it. So when you're doing your voice practices, the emphasis can be on the breath and the support so that you can then do whatever you want with your voice. So I feel very blessed to have her, and I've been taking lessons after much fear and consternation in the past, you know, 6 years, and I'll absolutely stick with them.
So she's teaching you more using your body to get the most out of your voice.
Absolutely, and that's going to be the foundation. The breath is going to be the foundation for any type of singing, whatever, you know, whether you're wailing on a metal song or doing punk music or folk music or classical, having that solid breath to let the voice float on it is great. And Megan's great for all sorts of metaphors and analogies to help you picture what you're doing with your body. Yeah, it's really great.
Good.
So, and actually was part of Amazon for a while, a couple of years ago, and having a great conductor really just brings a group together. And she's really talented at that. So I definitely recommend to everyone viewing to check out Amazon. They have bi-yearly concerts, and they're just a really great jewel in Urbana-Champaign.
And they're pretty open to membership.
Like, oh, absolutely.
People that want to sing with them.
Yeah, oh no, they're definitely open to membership. And the type of music that they undertake is across the vocal spectrum and international in flavor. So it's a great way to do interesting songs and not be stuck with traditional things that you might find in a traditional chorus.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We have another song we love.
Yeah.
Another original.
Yeah, I'll pull out another original. This is in the vein of, you know, music is such a great support to people through their lives, and whatever circumstance you're in, you can find a song that's going to either bring you out of it or support you in it, whatever that is. And so I was going through a challenging time a couple years ago, and so I wrote this song because I felt like, you know, whatever I was going through was going to pass at some point, you know. So on the days when I forgot that, couldn't quite see the light, or what I call the top of the mountain. If I couldn't see the top of the mountain, I could sing the song and remember that. Rising past old pain, She's rising.
So is that, you have a recording?
I do have a recording.
This is your chance to...
I have a recording that's, I can't even remember what it's called, but I do have a recording that you can find at my website, www.elizacorps.com.
That's E-L-I-Z-A-C-O-R-P-S.
That's right.
You don't know the name? Don't remember the name?
You know, it's something that I put together for the WRFU benefit. And let's just take a moment to say, WRFU, what a fantastic resource in the community, Radio Free Urbana. You can come up with a show, and it was a pleasure to be part of that benefit show. And so for that, I created a recording, and there's actually going to be a recording available of that whole concert as a fundraiser for RFU in the next month or so.
What's their call numbers?
WRFU. It's 104.5 FM, Urbana.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, why don't you... do another song here.
Yeah, let's see. Got a couple more. I will do, here's a song. When I got into jazz, I don't consider myself a guitarist primarily, I'm a vocalist. But I wanted to, you know, at least have a clue about jazz chords. So I had a friend, Paul Kotheimer, another fantastic musician in town, who sat down with me and showed me the basic chord formations, and then of course I had to do something with that. So this is a song that's called Her Trust, and it's based out of a line from a book by Italo Calvino called If on a Winter's Night, a Traveler, where there's a guy who comes to meet a woman, and her apartment's open, he's early, and he realizes he could snoop around everywhere, but if he did that, he would be negating the trust that she had given him that he could be there to begin with. So that was the spur, and the song went far, far away from there. If you take advantage of her trust, you don't deserve it. If you take advantage of her trust, you don't deserve it. She's tired of only having friends when they're orchestrated like instruments. She'd rather chance a fall and lose her pride. She has the patience of a saint if it's going to happen. She can't believe it won't happen. Would you take advantage of her trust when she offers so plainly? Why stay lonely? She can chew, but she knows it's just the right amount for two. All those things in her poetry could be true. But if you take advantage of her trust, you don't deserve it. If you take advantage of her trust, you don't deserve it. She's tired of of knowing eventually someone she'll meet will live up to her lifestyle. So darling, make it worth her while.
So you just recently learned the jazz? Did you just move to Champaign fairly recently?
Yeah, about 7 years ago.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so pretty quickly after that, met up with Paul.
Got those jazz chords down.
Got them down. And once you know, I mean, a lot of the, you, anyone who knows jazz knows that it's like, that was just a bunch of really standard things kind of mishmashed together, and it was great to do, so that's my jazz song, my original jazz song.
So you just have a good ear, that's how you can sync your voice with the chords so that you're on key. And
yeah, and I find that with a lot of music, but especially jazz and the tradition of improvisation, if you're running through the chords over and over in your head, and as I said, you know, riding your bike or walking around, you just kind of play out all the alternatives of what the melody could be. That's going to give you a lot of options, and then that gives you a foothold to when you encounter a new chord progression, because there's some basic patterns that you can kind of count on, and then from there you can swing freely throughout it. I've got another kind of a street ballad song that's a modern street ballad from Tracy Chapman, actually. And then I've got another one that maybe we can bring George out.
Yeah.
So this is called Behind the Wall. And it's a song about, well, as you're here, it's a song by Tracy Chapman about domestic violence.
Last night I heard the screaming, loud voices behind the wall. Another sleepless night for me, won't do no good to call the police, 'cause they always come late if they come at all. Last night I heard the screaming, loud voices behind the wall. Another sleepless night for me, won't do no good to call the police, 'cause they always come late if they come at all. And when they arrive, they say they can't interfere with domestic affairs between a man and his wife. And as they walk out the door, the tears well up in her eyes. Last night I heard the screaming, then a silence that chilled my soul. I pray that I was dreaming when I saw the ambulance in the road. And the policeman said, I'm here to keep the peace. Will the crowd disperse? I think we all could use some sleep. Last night I heard the screaming, loud voices behind the wall. Another sleepless night for me, won't do no good to call the police, 'cause they always come late if they come at all.
Why don't you just go into another song?
Yeah, all right, I'll do that. So this is my favorite. This is my new favorite song. It's actually my most recent song too. And that's probably why.
Where the evening's dark, but the morning's light. If you want something
let them be. Absolutely. Whatever, you know, no matter how things are, it's going to change. You know, another day's going to come.
Which kind of, you had an interesting story of kind of how you were in Champaign, and then you left, and then you came back.
Yeah, I came here because of a project called the School for Designing Society, and I moved here in 2001. And then at the end of 2004, I moved to New Orleans to be part of a community organizational effort down there around community takeover of school, actually. And that, of course, being 2005, ended up with Hurricane Katrina. And unfortunately, all of the forces that I was down there to try to address in terms of institutional racism got their full play as the aftermath of Katrina happened socially. And so I was, I evacuated and was all around the country, but coming back to Urbana, I found that Urbana was where I really had a community and where I really found support. So in 2006, I moved back here, and now I own a home here, and I call it home, and I plan to.
Fulfilling your life.
Absolutely, Urbana. You know, you never would guess that this fantastic place would be here in the middle of the Midwest, but it is, and it's wonderful.
Yeah. You ready to bring on George?
I would love to bring on George. George Turner, fantastic. Speaking of gems, I was really excited about jazz and cannot play jazz guitar very well, and so told this guy Palmer, who's a great music aficionado in town, and he said, well, you know, you should call up George Turner. Here's his email. Go talk to him. I think he might be interested. And so I did. That was last spring, and we've been playing together on and off ever since, and it's wonderful, wonderful.
Well, welcome, George. Glad to have you here.
Oh, thank you. It's good to be here.
So we've got a couple tunes to do. As the tube amp warms up.
Yes.
That's the old style.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
So the first song we're gonna do is "Don't Get Around Much Anymore." It's the Duke Ellington tune.
Saturday dance, heard they crowded the floor. I couldn't bear it without you. Don't get around much anymore. Thought I'd visit the club, got as far as the door. Well, they'd have asked me about you. Don't get around much anymore. Different without you. much anymore.
One of my favorite songs, called You've Changed. Thank you.
you ever cared, you've changed. You're not the angel I once knew. No need to tell me we're through. It's all over now, you've changed.
How do you work out your arrangements? Is that a standard arrangement, or do you have your own way of doing the arrangements?
I would defer to George.
It's pretty standard. You know, we just kind of messed around a little bit with changing the chords around a little bit, and of course, you know, Elizabeth is singing, you know, singing the melody in her own way, and you know, I'm doing some improvising, or you know, some fills, and you know, improvising in the solo. But as far as the basic form of the tune, it's pretty standard.
Mm-hmm. And we, you know, if we're doing something and say George is going through and he's soloing, and you know, we thought he was going to go one time through, but there's something really hot that he's doing, you know, he'll just keep going, and we just know that because we could tell, you know, I get the eyeball, you just know, so
you know
when you're coming
when
back
to,
in.
You know when to come back in.
Yeah, yeah. And the same thing on the endings and stuff, you just, you know, sometimes you're like, yeah, we're going to go through one more time because that's what it needs to do, and you just play it by ear, I guess. That's a really applicable use of that phrase.
Yeah.
Great. We've got another one. Oh, so this is what I talked about before, where, you know, there's traditional political songs, but then sometimes I cheat, and I change the lyrics of songs that exist. And I've done this, I do puppet shows, so I've done this for puppet shows in 2000. I was part of a puppet show called Goat with a Vote, and so I changed the lyrics to, there's a someone I'm longing to see, and it was about having a different candidate than our options were at that time. And then this song I was doing also at the Republican National Convention, just calling attention to that we have some class divisions in the United States that a lot of people aren't paying attention to. And at that time, everybody was talking about the economic boom, but there's plenty of people who are left out of an economic boom or an economic bailout, as we've recently seen,
yeah,
who are still struggling regardless of what's happened on Wall Street. So this is a borrowed, pardon us, Miss Holiday, borrowed from Billie Holiday version of God Bless the Child.
And that's God shall give, not shall lose. So big business says, and it still is news when millions are poor while the GNP soars. We read it in the paper and then forget, 'cause our needs are met. Already spent, I can work full time.
have time for one quick short one.
But all right.
I want to thank Elizabeth and George for coming on the show today.
Thanks so
much. I really enjoyed talking to you and listening to you. George has a website, georgeturnerjazz.com. And Elizabeth, excuse me, Elizabeth is elizacore.com. I want to thank Jason Liggett and UpTV for allowing us to do this. So you want to take us out with
great.
One last song?
We'll do that. How do you want to do? Just do it like the, it's pretty fast anyway.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, great. See, like that. That's how you arrange jazz songs.
I'm gonna love you like nobody's loved you. Come rain or come shine. High as a mountain, deep as a river, come rain or come shine. I guess when you met me, it was just one of those things. But don't ever bet me, 'cause I'm gonna be true if you let me. You're gonna love me like nobody's loved me, come rain or come shine. Happy together, unhappy together, and won't it be fine? Days may be cloudy or sunny, we're in or we're out of the money. I'm with you always, I'm with you rain or shine. Always hope.